Everybody, everybody's drinking. Everybody's drinking two martinis now. Come on.
Well, Claude, I think there's two things that if you're talking to at least five people a day, you're making offers. What I think the two things that are lacking is people not making an offer. People are afraid of the rejection. Sometimes whenever they come up with an objection, that's a lot of times a buying signal. That's not necessarily something negative.
Say that again. That was brilliant. Say that again.
An objection a lot of times is a buying signal. It's not necessarily a rejection.
Give me a rejection. Let's turn it into a buy. Let's turn it around.
Well, that sure is a lot of money, Claude.
You're right. You're right, Brandon. Can I call you Brandon? I'm Claude. Is that all right?
Yeah.
And you know, you're right. You didn't wake up this morning and say, I want to spend all $50,000 on an option on a home that, you know, I understand. It is a lot of money. Why do you think people pay that kind of money in previous deals I've done? Take a guess.
Because there's an upside to it.
Yeah. They get into a home today that they can buy tomorrow. You told me you're living with the five chihuahuas in a one bedroom condo near the garbage dump. And you said you're getting a little tired of that. I don't know why. It sounds like a reasonable rent you're paying.
Very affordable.
Very affordable. Maybe you should stay there another 5 years. It can't be, except for those few summer days in July when the smell and the heat and everything overpower you and make the dogs unhappy. It's probably not that big an obstacle, right?
Yeah, I do want a bigger place. I want to get out of here.
It's $50,000, but you know what? Can you imagine yourself in a home? Is that comfortable for your budget? I mean, maybe we should just call it quits right now anyway. If that's not practical.
Well, my only problem, Claude, is I only have $40,000 available.
That's a big problem. That's a big problem. Wow. I understand. So maybe it's over. Maybe we're done today.
I mean, would I be able to use a credit card for the other $10,000?
That's an interesting. Now, you must have brought that up for a reason.
I only have $40,000 in my savings account, but maybe I have a credit line from the credit union. I might be able to use that. I don't know.
Yeah, but originally you said the $50,000 was a lot of money. Are we past that now? If we can find a solution.
It is a lot of money.
You're right. I can't get it. But it's a beautiful house. It's worth $600,000. You and the doggies.
And my chihuahuas will have their own bedroom. So that's why I'm really excited about it.
Each of them.
This is a great role play. Thank you, Brandon. Does anyone see? Thank you. Give him a round. Yeah, that was a good one. He deserved it. These are spontaneous. We rehearse these for days, don't we, Brandon? And we write out all these complicated scripts in practice just before we come on here on Monday, right, Brandon?
Yep, scripts are great. No, they're caca.
This is spontaneous, impromptu, improvisational. But did you guys hear? Can someone give me an analysis? Did you hear a few guts moves in that really good conversation with Brandon? What did you hear?
Live five more years.
Did I argue with him about the $50,000?
Nope.
What would an amateur person do? Oh, no, it's 50. It's a wonderful price. Everybody pay. What did I do with him when he said, when he brought up the objection? Did I agree?
Maybe it's over.
Yeah, maybe it's over.
Maybe it's, I'm firing him. I'm pushing him away. What do we call that when you push the prospect away?
Negative redirection.
Little scarcity, huh? Yeah. Little scarcity, little reverse psychology. Now you probably can't do it. And he said, that's a lot of money. Did I argue with him? What did I say?
It is.
You agree with him.
You're right. I'm not disagreeing with you. Yeah. You're right. Why am I agreeing with Brandon when he brings up a stall or an objection? Why is it important to acknowledge it? If it's a reasonable objection, should you argue with him or agree with him?
Agree.
Why? Agree. Why?
Creating empathy.
It makes person to trust you more.
Keep going.
You are not manipulating, at least in his mind.
You're right, Brandon. But go ahead.
You are manipulating, but he doesn't feel it. He feels like you on his page. You know his pain. And yes, you are a real person. So it's nice to talk to you.
Right. And then I made the move. First, I agree with him. I'm nurturing him along. I'm not here to argue with him or go into sales presentation mood. I'm here to keep that emotion. It's a lot of money. You're right. And everything. But then I went into something called social proof from Robert Cialdini. If you haven't read that book, for the new people on here today, you got to read it. I went into something called social proof. Gee, why do you think so many people pay me that money? Or why do you think so many people invest that kind of money? That's a question. So basically, it's a redirection with social proof and a question to Brandon. What does that force Brandon to do?
To continue a conversation with you.
And be one of them.
I want to join the club. I want to be part of, Joseph is right. I want to be one of them. This is complicated shit, isn't it?
But hey, Claude, I got a question. You know, I doesn't.